الوهاب الذي ليس كمثله شيء وهو السميع البصير أمرنا بعبادته وقال وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون وما أريد منهم أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو قوة المتين.
All the praises be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who give us opportunity to worship Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our prayers.
Amen.
We testify there is no God worthy to be worshipped except Allah. And we testify our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a beloved of Allah, the messenger of Allah. Allah sent him to the all mankind, all generation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because of the honor, Allah honor Prophet Muhammad. Because of that honor, Allah make us, we are also honorable people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always mention in the Quran, the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are the best ummah Allah has ever created. So we take this opportunity to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala making us the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One time Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, Allah show him something, a place in Jannah. And then Musa asked, Ya Allah, this particular place is for who? Allah said, ذَلِكَ لِأُمَّةٍ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمٍ. This particular place is kept for Ummah of Prophet Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمٍ. That is why Musa said, I wish to be among the Ummah, not a messenger, to be the Ummah like you and I. What a wonderful chance that we have. We have to make use of this chance and worship Allah. May Allah accept our prayers.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed as a human being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran clearly, saying, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي Adam. Indeed, the son of Adam is creation. The way we created him, Allah said, the way I created a human being, I perfected him. هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ سُوَّرَكُمْ. He is the one who created you and perfected you. Subhanallah. When you look at the other creation, Allah could have created you to become a tree. Allah would have created you to become an animal with the four legs, eating with your mouth. Subhanallah. But Allah chose to create you a human being. And you are best. And you, Allah love you. Allah regard you more than the angels. That's why Allah make angels to become your servant. When you see in the Quran, Allah said, we created malaika. Each and every one of us, every day two angels are guiding you. What a wonderful blessing. Not the angels who are writing Rakib wa Atid. No, there are two angels following you, guiding you. Especially when you are Muslim and they are blessing you every single day. That is how Allah honors a human being. What are we giving Allah in return? Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khalaqana li'ibadati. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors us, but He tells us, I created you to come and recognize me and worship me. That is what I want from you. Because through the worship, you make this world a better place for everybody to live in. Muslims are supposed to make this world a better place, comfortable for everybody to live in. Allah order us, amarana bi'ibadati. Allah order us to worship Him. Not only that, Allah did not just say, come, worship me. No, Allah arsala ilayna rusulan. And then Allah sent messengers for us. Mubashirin, to come and give us glad tidings. Munzirin, to come and warn us when we refuse to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَكَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ عُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا. Indeed, we have sent a messenger to every nation. What is the message? أَنَعْبَدُ اللَّهِ, for them to worship Allah. وَاجْتَنِبُ التَّعْبُودِ, for them to forbid worshiping idols. So every ummah was sent a messenger. And then Allah said, وَمَا كُنَّا مُعَذِّبِينَ حتى نبعث رسولا. We shall not punish you except we send a messenger to you. He will tell you to do this. When you refuse, there we have excuse to punish you. What a wonderful justice. Nobody is justice like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Truth is justice. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the day of judgment day, those who wrong Allah, they are going to hellfire. Allah will give them mouth to ask Allah. And then Allah will ask them, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي السَّقَرُ. Subhanallah. Allah will give them answer, the mouth for them to testify for what they did. Allah will ask them, why are you in this saqar, the hellfire? مَا سَلَكَكُمْ. What take you in this hellfire? They will give answer. قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُوْ. We are not among those who worship Allah. That is why we are going to hellfire today. And they repeat, وَلَمْ نَكُنْ نُطْعِمُ الْمِسْكِينَ. And we don't even encourage people to do what? To feed the poor ones. Our religion is teaching us to be brother keepers, to keep the world safe. That is why Sayyidina Umar, when he was Khalifa, he go around in Medina to collect tax from everybody to give the poor people. Now, we are not in the nation of Islam where there is no Khalifa to collect the money from us. It left with us, our conscience, to give this out to the poor people. That is what Islam teaches us, to give poor. When you have your neighbor who is poor, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ مِنَّا مَنْ بَاتَ شَبْعَانْ وَجَارُؤُ جَاعُمْ. It is not among ummah. I will not call you my ummah, among my ummah. When you sleep, your house comfortable, you are belly, your belly is full. مَنْ بَاتَ شَبْعَانْ. You slept, your belly is full. وَجَارُؤُ. Your neighbor, جَاعُمْ, is in hunger. And that your jar, no, regardless of who he is, whether he's idol worshiper, you must feed him as a Muslim. That is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to tell the ummah. So brothers and sisters, this is our religion. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do. This is what he asks us to do. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you human being, since Allah created the world, he's talking to human being. أَفَأَسِبْتُمُ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Are you thinking we sent you, we created you to come to the world to play amusement, to just play? أَفَأَسِبْتُمْ. Do you think that is the reason why we created you? When you look at the Muslims and the non-Muslims, you can see these differences. Muslims always think how he will do for Allah to appreciate him. Those who don't know Allah, they are thinking the world is for what? Is for playground. They always create what will make them happy. Abathan. And then Allah said, wa annakum ilayna la turja'un. You think you will not come back to me? You think I just created you to come and play? You will not come back to me? Fata'ala Allah malikul haq. This Allah is more exalted than this. لا إله إلا هو. It is worthy to be worshipped. No anyone worthy to be worshipped except him. ملك رب العرش الكريم. The king who dominates the dominion. He is the one who created you to come and worship Allah. But you come, you change, you chose another way. Brothers and sisters, in other ayah, and this ayah goes to all of us. We have to be very, very careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I read in Surah An-Nisa, Allah said, لَيْسَ بِأَمَانِيِّكُمْ وَلَا بِأَمَانِي أَحْلِ الْكِتَابِ مَنْ يَعْمَلُ سُوءًا يُجِزَ بِهِ. Allah said, not your wishes or the wishes of people of the book, that you think because of your wishes Allah will spare you while you are on the surface of earth, you as a Muslim creating sin. Allah said, no, wallahi, whether you are a Muslim, you are worshipping five daily prayers, when you create sin, Allah said, I will punish you. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا يُجْزَ بِهِ. ليس بأمانيكم. Because Muslimin, when the Ahl al-Kitab, the Jews and the Christians, they are telling Muslimin, نحن أبناء الله وأحباه. We are the children of Allah and we are the lovers of Allah. Allah loves us. And they say, Allah will never put us into hellfire illa ayyaman ma'dudat. Even if Allah put us in hellfire, it's just a mere 3 days or 4 days, Allah will take us out because Allah loves us. And then Muslims were also saying, they were telling the Jews and the Christians, you think you are best religion? We Muslims, Allah said, inna deena inda Allah al-Islam. The best religion is Islam. And Allah said, we are the best ummah. So these two groups, everyone have his own advantage. But Allah said, all of you leave it. ليس بأمانيكم ولا بأماني أهل الكتاب من يعمل سوءا يجزى به. Anybody who commits sin, Allah will punish you. Sayyidina Abu Bakr رضي الله عنه, he said, يا رسول الله, this ayah, Allah said, من يعمل سوءا